Hola amigos, welcome back to another episode of Project Ozone. And I was going to start with the creation of this crossbow and the bolts, but I think I'm going to put that at the end of the episode like a bonus, because you have seen me do that a lot of time if you have following the other series. So that's what we're going to do. But already, actually, I just got a modifier. Signalum Bolt and plus one Smite and plus one Attack, which is really nice, actually. It's not that bad. It has Reinforced 1 and Quartz already, and this one has Moss 2, Smite, and Reinforced 2. And that's because, well, you can see at the end of the video, but what I did for the Tough Binding, I used Adamantine that I had a little bit. The rest is Signalum. And also I use this, the tool rod I use for the bolts at the mountain as well, because, it was a little bit left on the smelter there. And it turned out it's really nice. Now, this is not the first bolt that I made, actually. I made two more before, same material, Signalum and the mountain. But this one, I got Bane of Anthropos. So I'll save it in there, but I started a new one. And then I got the knockback on this one. So these were the two first one, second one, and this is the third one. And so far I'm liking what I see, so I'm gonna keep that one. And of course, you can see that it's really, really fast to kill all the mobs. One shot almost everything. So really nice. And we can use it because I do want to go to the Nether, probably in this episode or the next one. We'll see. In this episode, I don't know why I took the long route. In this episode, actually, what I wanted is start a little bit of automation on the sieving. Now, we saw the other day that was really cool. Kinda Jan has a great idea that she told me, why don't you use the three autonomous activated in one sieve? Now, it makes sense that it will be faster to sieve one piece, but I just wanted the three different kind of like the sand and gravel to sieve, just so I can see what kind of materials I have and everything. What I can do actually with the autonomous excavator and the vacuum hopper is grab my stuff in there. Let me go to sleep very fast. Grab my experience, actually. And I think it's a good idea. We can use that because I don't see me using the autonomous activator for anything else at the moment. So I'm going to make a tank, actually a drum, sorry. And that's only iron, and that's iron. We have ton, actually. So I think it's two of you. Okay, and we can make a drum. So with this drum, what we can do is put the autonomous activator and the vacuum hopper. So I can put you there, right here. So that will, as soon as we have an essence in here, it will right-click the essence. But at the same time, I want it to capture the essence from here, for example. So if we go here, as soon as you have an essence, you're going to put it right in here. Okay, so it goes directly there. And also the experience, put it on the top. So in the top, we're going to put it like this. And I'm going to put the drum right there. So there you go. All right, so as soon as we'll wait for it, but as soon as this one has a little bit of anything, this will go green and grab the experience. So we'll take a look at that after. I hope that will work like this. Okay, so what I started making is because I want to go to Ender.io, so I already started a conduit binder that is really, this binder composite really easy, gravel, sand, and clay, that we can get our hands on very easily. And when you smelt that, you get this conduit binder that you can use after for a lot of stuff, but especially, of course, for the item conduits and stuff like that. And this is where I want to go, item conduits. Now, we need these pulsating ingots also. So I needed the alloy smelter, and that's one of the things I crafted already. And we have it here. So we have an alloy smelter. We have a sterile generator. We have a bunch of pipe. The pulverizers, actually, I'm going to put this in here for now. So I made some energy conduits already. And if we take a look at the quest book, we have one here. Oh, to the Nether. Okay, that one, because I was getting ready to go to the Nether. So we can claim this reward. Let's see what we get. A good one. And very bad rewards, as always. Okay, let's... Oh, the last time I was kind of cool. Kind of cool rewards I had. I'm going to take the copper away from here. And I think that's it. These lapis lamps are really cool because we can probably use them on the farm to see a little bit more, but not that I need to, because they do not remove, they don't generate light like that. So this copper I'm going to put in here for now. As you can see, iron, we have ton. Tin, copper, I've been smelting a little bit of all this stuff in here. So we do have a lot of materials so far. But of course, we want more. Now, let's see at the quest book in here. And this is another aspect. You can craft the end portal. This I saw you, I show you already on Cacophony how to do the spectral key and go to that dimension. This will do probably to visit other stuff. Now, let's go back in here for a second. I want to do the automatic sieving. But before we do that, I want to generate, start generating a little bit more power. And since we have a lot of lava, we can start with a heat generator. So I'm going to craft that one, heat generator. Let's see the recipe for a second. Copper, furnace, osmium, and iron. So do I have some copper in here? Yes. Okay, the only thing we need is some osmium. Where are you? Osmium. I know I smelted some. Yeah, there you go. Okay, so we have that in there. So let's craft... I needed three. Okay, let's craft three to start with. I need a couple of furnace. One, two, three. And I think that's it. There you go. We have three. Oh, they don't stack. Okay. And these ones require... do I have another tank? This has a little bit of the stabilized redstone from other stuff. Let's see. From the signalum, yeah, that I crafted. What I need is another tank. Let's craft another tank very quickly. So I know it's copper and some of you, at least for 8 buckets. And that's where my Invar went, because I was looking at my Invar. I don't have any more. I use it to craft this tank. I think I use all my Invar left, because this one is a mid bucket as well. Okay, it doesn't matter. We'll grab that one for now. We'll put some in here. Some, there you go. Let's grab some of you. And I'm gonna need some lava, so let's grab a little bit of lava. How much? 5, 6, 7, 8, and I'm gonna grab a bucket. Okay, so where should we put this? I was thinking that maybe I could do something under here, where all our cables are gonna go. So maybe that's an idea. So let's grab another piece of bucket, and we'll grab a little bit of water and some cobblestone. So that's what I need. And I think I made this platform so we can work in here. And you know what? Instead of wasting time on that, I'm just going to put the generators in here. And then when I have more time, because I do want to record a couple of episodes before I go away, I want to beautify that when I come back. So let's put, actually, I would like lava underneath. So what do we have there? Oh, perfect. Okay. So we can put, let's see here. Okay, we can put one there. We can put another one there. No, I'm going to put them. I'm going to put this sideways. Okay, let me grab you and you. And so I have more space in here to work with. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, I'm going to beautify after. So lava is going to go. If you're going to go there, lava is going to go there. It's going to go there and there. And this one, we can put the other one right here. And we'll do something like that. And the other one is going to be there. We'll do something like that. And then we can close. But it will be better when I have more time. So let's put some lava and start with that. So the way this works, you can actually put lava directly. So I can put a bucket in here and it will generate that power. But you have to keep putting buckets of lava or pump some lava in. So, but you can do it like this and it will start generating a little bit of heat, as you can see from that. And what I noticed in the quest is say, yes, I made it a bit better. Place heat generator on top of lava or place lava in heat generators. I don't know what's the producing 1248 joules a tick. I don't know, 300 joules a tick. Not 100% sure how much is that. I'm not used to joules and stuff like that, but I think it will generate more if I put some lava on all the sides and actually including in the bottom here, so we can put some lava there. And then we can close that. So not 100% sure. Now, of course, it's storing all that stuff and it's not using it, so we cannot see actually that. But yep, we have some lava there. So let me remove you in there and remove you as well in there. And we'll put some lava in here as well and some lava in there as well. Oh, we can claim the quest, right? No, that's because this is not the next quest. Okay, let's finish this up by putting some more lava on the sides. There you go. A little bit there, and that is empty. So I'm missing one more actually. So let's grab it directly from here. Okay. And we have that in there. And it probably will be a good idea to cover that up at one point. Especially I don't like to have it like this. So we could, and this is where I put all my materials and stuff in here also. Let's cover it with half slabs so we don't have any spawning either. So we'll do something like this for now. Okay. There you go. And let's cover you like that. 1, 2, 3, 7. I'm not going to have enough for that, so I'm going to leave it like that. Now let's put some cables. So I crafted a redstone furnace, and I was just trying to figure out if this is a basic one, because look at the speed at how it's melt. And yeah, the tip that I made a basic casing, so look at that. It's absolutely insane. Because if you go here, let me grab actually something else I need to smelt. Let's grab some tin, for example. So instead of using the smelter, forget about that. If you have a pulverizer, let's actually open, let's close everything. We'll put the result. Actually, I don't want to put the byproduct. So just this one, and you take whatever it comes from here. So let's see. Where's my tin? Okay, tin. Look, like a stack of 20, done, basically. There you go. All right, guys, I'm almost back. I'm back, actually. So I forgot to put some power on this. Forgot those thing had this power. So, but still, I don't have anything that has grown yet. But it should work. It should work as soon as this grow, and we'll see that green. I can always put whatever I have in here. I have some essence right here. It will right-click them, and it will. This will absorb and put it in there. But we'll see if I've, after we finish what we're gonna do, we'll have some experience in that tank. I'm gonna grab some of you for a second. I already crafted an automatic hammer and a bunch of sieves, three specifically. Actually, I didn't complete that quest. Oh no, it requires speed upgrades and some fortune upgrades. Yeah, I'm gonna. Let's see here. What do we need? Invar, Electrum, and Pyrotium. No, I don't have Sulfur. I think I don't have Sulfur. Because I think I used them all. Oh, look at that. We have one. Okay, so we could actually craft... we need how many? Recipe is one for this one. What about the other one? Electrum, Invar... Actually, we can craft them. We can craft them as well. Let's see, we need some coal as well. Let's grab two pieces of coal, two of you for the Pyrotium. No, actually, I need only one, right? Let's see, it's one Pyrotium. Okay, so sulfur, coal powder, one of you, and a piece of redstone, if I recall correctly. Some invar that I put in here some. Or did I put it here? Okay, I put it here. Let's do this one. Very fast. I have some electrum. So I need a piece of coal. Let's put furnace. Actually, I can pulverize in here. And let's just stop in here. Pulverize you. And do something like that. Pyrotium. Perfect. And we'll do a speed upgrade first. So, speed upgrade. Let's see. Electrum ingots. Okay, let's grab an electrum ingot. And we should be able to do this one. Very nice. Should I make... Yeah, let's make four. Why not? And the fortune upgrade is a diamond... only. So let's do that one. Fortune upgrade. So it should be something like this, right? I'm failing. Electrum nuggets. I'm gonna need a little bit more. So let's use you like so. Electrum nuggets. Maybe it was something like this. Yes. Okay. So that should complete that quest. And we get our reward back. Let's grab the middle one. Let's see. Greater. Oh, that's not bad. That's not bad. Let's see. I don't have any more space, so I'm going to open it in a second. What I want to do here, I want to get the coal, the cobblestone right from here. This is just going to be a test just to see how it works. So if we grab... the coal from here, okay, it's grabbing, and we have a bunch of, I think I have a bunch of speed upgrades, or no, I had some war interaction upgrades, okay. Let's grab the hammer, we'll put it in here, that should get all that, and it needs power that we have all the way over there. So, I'm gonna have to, let me craft more of you, what do you need? Conductive iron, so is redstone, and okay, let's see, we have iron, we have redstone, let's grab 10 more, and 10 more iron as well. Okay, let's put that in there, because I have the rest, and that's insane, the speed of that machine, it is really insane, so I need alloys only, so 10 and 10. That should give me that. And conduit binder, I already have some. So let's see. We'll grab some. This is really slow. That one is, of course, really slow. I'm just going to put some more in there. At least these each give me 8, I think. Come on. Oh, no, that's the binder. Okay, yeah, but I need 3 more. The last time I did it on there. Let's see, pulverizer, there's no way. I don't have an alloy smelter on that. Alloy, what do we have? That's the only one, I think. A lawyer. Just what I needed, a lawyer. Okay, let's go and grab the sterling for now so we can test it. You're not doing anything, right? Yeah, you're chilling there, so let's grab you. Actually, give me the... Okay, where the hell are you? Did I just lose the sterling generator? Oh, it went here. Okay. I was scared for a second there. Okay, I'm going to put the sterling generator right here for now. We'll test it with you. So, this should start hammering this. Let's put some speed upgrades. So, we get the gravel. And, oh, what I need is some conduits that I forgot. So, Ender IO. Ender IO conduits. There you go. Where are the conduits? Right here. So pulsating iron. I think I have pulsating iron from loot bags. Yes. Okay. So let's see. Just the conduit binder and the pulsating ingots. Conduit binder. I have a few in there. So let's make some nuggets for now. We'll do it like this and something like that. Oh, that'll give me plenty for now. Okay. Okay, so let's grab it from this side just to test it out. So if I grab it from there, I want to just put in there and grab the automatic sieve. Let's put some power right here. Actually, I have it in here, the power, right? So let's grab you for now. And put some power to this one as well. Okay. And in this, this is the fun part. Not only you can put these electric conduits in there. So let's say, let me remove this one for a second. Let's say I have my power from here. Okay. So I can send the power to this machine from there. And these actually, I can also combine, of course, with the same. So if I go in here and I put like this and like this, both the item conduits and the energy are going to the same space in here. So which is really nice. So let's right click in there. And what I want is this actually in here, the item. I don't want to connect it to that. Not that it's going to make any difference, because it's actually will make a difference. I don't want to take that anything. So in here, whatever the result here that is gravel, I want it in here. Now from there, I want to go right here. And let's say we have a chest there where we want to put everything, right? So let's grab a chest from here. Oops. Okay. And just to give it a test. Where is my chest? Oh no. Switch to inventory mode and placement mode. Inventory mode and placement mode on this machine is when you're using the little robots. We're going to take a look at that after, but let me take a chest. And we'll put a chest right here for now, just to test the thing. Okay, so from here, I wanted to go there. Let's use extract. And in here, We're going to go insert. That's simple. It goes from one machine to the next one. And then in here, actually what I can do in here is green channel extract, green channel insert. And in here, actually, yeah, instead of putting it like that, I'm going to go in and out, insert on green, extract on brown. Okay, so let's activate that. And in this one, I'm going to go insert on brown. So there you go. That's how it works. So it's going to take on the green channel, put it in there, and then on the brown channel and put it in there. And really cool, really cool. We can put the... we put in here the speed, right? How are you doing on speed? I'm going to have to put more speed. So let me put for now two there and two there. And can I put the fortune as well? There you go. So that's going to go a little bit faster. It's going to use a ton of energy though. So there you go. I grab you and I can make more energy conduits. You go there. So I can put you like so and make more energy conduits. And maybe I can grab this. But this is actually temporary. I'm not going to leave it in there. I'm going to make another one of these cobblestone gen to do this one. But at least we're getting some stuff in there. I'm going to set up something a little better than this for the next episode. And I'll explain it how it works. But you see the gist of it. It's really, really simple. When you have those colors channel, you can grab from one, put in the other one, and then move all that. So I can have a bunch of hammers doing gravel, sand, dust, and whatever. Look at that sound. It creeped me out the first time I hear it. But I know it's this stuff in there. Yeah, so I think it's going to be a good... Oh, boy. It hurt. And look at that, we have an ender pearl. Perfect. Okay, so so we can have several hammers, several auto sieves, and then go everything to here. And once it's in there, actually, what we can do is auto craft. We have the packager. Sorry about that. We have the where is it? Yeah, this one here, the auto packager. I don't really like the auto packager. Let's craft one very fast just to demonstrate. Where is it? Let's see. Auto packager. I need three pistons. Can I do three pistons? Yeah, actually, I have one in there. So. Let's do that one. Three piston, a crafting bench. And what else I need? A redstone reception coil. Can I do redstone reception coil? I need a piece of gold. Let's actually put this stuff in here. Okay, so let's do you. And let's do the auto packager. Auto packager. What this will do, and let me take another chest from here. Do they require power? Yeah, I think they do. Okay, so let's just put it in here for testing. So if I put a chest right here, and I put the auto packager right here. Okay. And you see, I right click, it say 2x2, then 3x3. I shift right click, it will say 2x2 only, 3x3, hollow. What I want is a 2x2 only, because I know this kind of stuff, for example, the broken aluminium, you have to combine it like that. So If we put some power in it, and there's nothing here, but if we put some power, there you go, we should see the stuff coming together really nice, actually. That's not bad. I thought it was lower than this. Okay, so everything that is combinable by two, you can combine it like that. Actually, I think I'm going to keep this in my setup. That's, yeah, definitely. So, look at that. We do a row of gravel, a row of sand, a row of dust, and we put an auto packager after each of these. And that's not bad. So, actually, what we can do... Yeah, I think I need a chest anyway in there. Yeah, that's not bad. Look at that. We get a gravel, and then the gravel from this, we could also automate further. But we run out of time, I think. So let me check before I go if that's working. That is not working. Or this hasn't gone. This hasn't gone. Hasn't grown already. So I don't know. I'm not sure about that. Why you're not growing? But I know that once this grow, that will right click absolutely, and then is going to absorb the essence, right click the essence, and then put the experience on my tank. So if I throw a bunch of this stuff in there, it should absorb them, right click them. You see how it's right clicking and making the experience, and then the experience is going up. So I know, because I've done it in the past, I think in Feed the Beast Monster or something like that. These are very old setups, and a little beautiful setup that of course, but yeah. All right, guys, so I think that's going to be it for this episode. I'm going to work on making a little bit more auto packagers and this thing here. I'm going to make also sieves. We have but some automatic hammers as well. And what I want to do as well is try to decorate this a little better. I was thinking that maybe, and let me know what you think of it, expand all these in here and make it a little taller, like a platform, so I can go down, and all this in here, this area is gonna be the farming stuff, because once we get into magical stuff, we're gonna need some place for auto farming and stuff like that. Yeah, I think that's gonna be it, guys. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy it, and see you next time. Bye-bye. Actually, before I go, I forgot to open my greater warbag, so let's take a look. Dirt, great. And since we're here, I'm gonna remove this for a second, and let's open at least one, and we have the chains cube scanner. Let me just save a little bit of my experience. I make this drain, by the way, so I can per my experience right here. And let's grab this just in case, and a chance cube. There you go. And let's test it out. Let's see if we get lucky with something really good. Last time we got lucky. And let's put in here, what is this? So chance cube scanner, you can scan. The chance of this cube is 64, which I don't know what the hell that means. But I do know that some pendants will help you to get better chance, better luck at least. So how do you craft this? Oh, look at that. It's really complicated to craft. Well, not complicated. It needs the pendant already, so I'm going to save that. Let's save this in here for now. So 64. We'll see if 64 is good or bad in a second, but I'm guessing not that great. Oh, not that bad at all. Look at that. Pigs and sheep. Well, not that we need, but we have some cows and some fence already to put them in there. Nice. Very cool, actually. Not bad at all. So look at that. Sheep, cows, and that. Oh, we got the Ender Lily and other very cool stuff last episode. These Ender Flux crystals. All right, guys. See you. Thank you.